A new update to Revit 2024 has just been released, so now we have Revit 2024.1. I'm going to be showing you how to download and install this update, and then I'm going to be showing you some of the new features that we get with this update. So now we actually have a feature where we can simplify a complex topo surface. I'm going to be showing you how you can now export the fill patterns, how you can zoom in and out of your project browser, and some of the other really interesting new improvements and updates to Revit. Now, this isn't a major new release, so this isn't like Revit 2025 or something like that. It is a minor release. However, we do get some interesting updates, and that's what I'm going to be showing you today. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours of content dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics in Revit. So now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into, well, Autodesk.com. So I'm on the Autodesk website because first I want to show you how to do the actual update. So you want to make sure you're signed in, then you want to go to your products and services or product updates. I prefer to use this approach. So then here, what you want to do is you just want to search for Revit. Okay, here we have Revit, then you go to view details, and then here we have the updates as the first option, and this is where our Revit 2024.1 update is located at. So we can just go here and click on download, and that's going to download the 1 gigabyte pack or 1.4 gigabyte pack, and now we can update Revit. Okay, so once the file is downloaded, you just click on it and it's going to start the installation process. There we go, so it's extracting right now. We just want to click yes. And here we just want to install the update. So it's going to take some time for it to install, and then I'm going to be showing you all of the new features. And as you can see, now we have our update, which is successful. So I'm just going to hit finish here, and now we can start Revit. Now, once Revit is started, you'll notice everything pretty much looks the same. It's even going to remember all of your recent files, but here, up here on top, it's going to say Revit 2024.1, and now let's explore the new features. With the new release of Revit 2024, we got topo solids instead of topo surfaces. This was the major change. This is what most of the comments were on, and I think it makes sense to start from the new updates to the topo solids tool. So now with a topo solid, and here I have this large topo solid, what you'll notice is we have the topo solid shaping, here we have the subdivide, but now we also have the simplified topo solid tool. So in this case, I have a very complex topo solid. If I go here to modify subelements, you can see this is actually how many points we have, so that's quite a lot of points. Now, if you were to try to make a change to this topo solid, well, it would take a lot of time just having to move individual points one by one. Now, with the Simplify Topo Solid tool, what we can do is just select the topo solid, go to Simplify Topo Solid, and then it tells us here we have 1880 points, and how many of these points would we like to keep. So if I go and say 30%, you can see it's going to keep 500 points. If I say 20%, it's going to keep 376 points. If I do something like this, you're going to notice the topo solid will change a little bit. It just has to, it's obvious, just because it can't keep the same shape with so many fewer points. However, if I go here to modify subelements, you can see that now we have a lot fewer points. And if I would like to make a change, it's a lot easier for me to make that change like this when we don't have as many points. Let's just bring this down a little bit. Okay. So something that they've noticed here, I'm not really sure how they do this, but it does look like it didn't just kind of randomly remove points. It did try to remove the points which were least necessary, at least from kind of the remaining points and their just how they're spread apart. So I think this was designed as kind of a smart way to simplify the topo surface without taking away from its shape too much. Now again, on the topic of TopoSolids, previously we didn't really have the ability to select all instances of subdivisions in a view or in a project, so when you select it, it just didn't give you this option. Luckily, this is fixed with this new update, so now if I select one of these subdivisions, which I have here, right-click and then go to select all instances, I can select all in view, so it's just going to make it a lot easier for me to select all of the subdivisions on projects where I have many. Moving forward, let's now talk about some of the changes made to the properties and project browser panels. So now if I select any field here in the properties panel, if I use the up and down arrows, I can actually toggle through all of the parameters which we have here, which is really useful. The same thing goes here for the project browser. I can use the arrow keys to move up and down throughout our project browser. One more major change to the project browser is now I can zoom in and out by holding the control key, and I can actually zoom out of the project browser, making it smaller, or zoom in, making it larger. So you just hold the control key and then you can zoom in and out. I think this is really useful. When I read about this new change, it did sound a little bit weird. However, now when I'm testing it out and playing around with it a little bit, I think it is really useful to be able to see just a little bit more in that small project browser window. Now let's talk about fill patterns and the update for exporting fill patterns. So here we have some floors with some fill patterns, and let's say you've created a fill pattern, or you're just seeing a nice fill pattern which you would like to share with somebody. Well, now we can actually export those. So if I go here to the Manage tab and then go to Additional Settings, here I can find fill patterns, open that up, and now what you'll see is if I select any one of these fill patterns, we now have the export selected fill pattern to path file button. So now when I select this, I can just figure out a folder, I can name it export fill pattern, for example, and then I can hit save, and now we have actually exported and saved this particular fill pattern. Then moving forward on the topic of annotation, here we have some text, and now if I select this text, I can go here to alignment and I can align it pretty much however I like. Now previously, if I were to have multiple sets of text, multiple instances of text, and if I wanted to set the alignment for both of those, well, I would have to do for each one pretty much individually. I couldn't select both and then set the alignment for both texts at once. Now, with the new version, I can just go here, copy this text, hit the escape key a couple of times, select both instances of text, and now I can align them both however I like. Now let's talk structure. So before this update, if we had a beam in Revit, we could use the split tool to split that beam. However, we couldn't use the split with gap. So if I wanted to assign a certain gap when splitting a beam, that wouldn't work. Now with the updated Revit 2024.1, if I go here to the Modify tab, I can obviously use still the split tool to split the beam. And then if I go here to split with gap and assign a gap which I would like to use, well, it's going to split that beam. However, when I've tested this, it doesn't seem to create a gap, which is odd. So perhaps you have a solution for this, why this is happening, why it still doesn't split with a gap. So it does split the beam, it just doesn't introduce the gap we were promised. And finally, for structure, there are some changes in terms of the rebar behavior. So previously, when we select rebar, we couldn't really make any changes numerically. So we could drag it in the model and change it, or we can make some numerical changes in the properties panel. However, we couldn't make numerical changes in the model itself. So now this has been changed. So now here I am in the same model. If I select this piece of rebar, now you can see here we have those same values which we have in the properties panel, and I can actually change those here numerically instead of having to go to the properties panel, which is a nice upgrade. Now, also something that that we had previously, or where we have a new update, is in terms of a rebar dimensioning. So for rebar dimensioning, we have this multi-rebar annotation. Previously, when we would place this, it would just, when we click on the tool, it would just go and allow us to place the tool. However, now, with the updated version, if I click on the multi-rebar tool, here we have the pick position option where I can just pick the position and then place the rebar. So that's just a minor difference, but it is something that's new for the multi-rebar annotation. So there we go. That's going to conclude this video. As I said, that this isn't some major changes. However, it is some small improvements in quality of life for us Revit users. I hope you have enjoyed this. Please tell me in the comment section below what do you think about the new updates and what's the next thing that you would like to see updated or added to Revit. Of course, if you want to get access to all of my Revit project files, I've got over 500 files on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.